Okay, this is a simple circuit of the rectifier, silicon control rectifier alarm. I'll quickly explain how it works. Okay, what I've done in this circuit, I've used 4 SCRs. As you can see, these are the SCRs. They conduct one side, they conduct like diodes, but you have to trigger this side. Each of these sites, you trigger them. That's how they work, the SCR. And then I've used one transistor. The transistor is there to receive any of the signals from the SCR into these diodes, small diodes, and then into the base of this transistor through a resistor, and then switches on this transistor. And as a result, it brings the 0 volts into this buzzer here. And then it will switch on this LED here. And then I've also used another LED for indicating power. So this LED here and that LED there, they've got green colors. I've decided to use green colors for this. And for all of these LEDs, I've used a red color. These red colors, they represent that there's an intruder coming into your home or your business whatsoever. So the way this circuit is designed is such that it has got 4 normally opened switches that are representing the PIRs, and then it's got 4 normally closed switches that represent the normally closed PIRs, a passive infrared sensor that you normally find in homes, businesses whatsoever for butler alarm. So, and then for simplicity, I made it such that when you switch on, it will indicate with the green LED that there is a power in the circuit, meaning also at the same time, the switch that represents the on power, it also arms the alarm. So if anything triggers the alarm, maybe any of these get to be closed or any of these gets to be open, it will ring a siren here. Now, let us see how it works in practical. Okay, this is how it works in practical. All these switches are closed. They represent the section of the normally closed PIR, and all these places are opened. They represent this other section of PIRC where there's open switches or open sensors. So what I will do now, I will switch on our butler alarm. Now, notice here, I don't know if you can see, you will notice that when I switch on our butler alarm, the green LED will come in, as you can see here. The green LED is now on, and then if anything happens, like triggering this circuit, or maybe if there's an intruder, just to put it straight, like for instance, I will put in an intruder in zone number 1 by closing the switch here. Okay, just a bit. See, this PIR here was disturbed by an intruder, so it turned on. Even here, when I switch off, when I open this circuit and close it, it will remain on. It doesn't matter whether the intruder is in or out. It'll just, as long as it gets to be triggered once, it will then ring an alarm. Like here, I'm going to disturb the second zone. You see, the second LED went on, and then I'm going to disturb the third one now. You see, the third one is on. So it will continue ringing a siren like this until it gets to be resetted, like switching it off. Okay, switching it off. And then it will go back to the reset state. Now, this is for 8-room household or house or a business with whichever place where you decide to put it, but it is for 8 rooms. And then instead of putting this switch here, you can put in your receiver, and then you control it via remote so that you tuck in your alarm system somewhere. And then you only take this LED to represent that is armed only when you pressed your remote to close the switch via receiver. Then it will indicate with this LED, and then you'll know that, okay, my alarm system is on. And then if any of these PIRs that are connected here gets to be disturbed, it will ring an alarm. That's how it works. That's simple. And then, as you can see, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 SCRs, which are these here. Okay, let me do this. Which are these here. And then this part here is the transistor, which is represented by this. So it's 4 SCR, 1 transistor, 4 LEDs. So they share, because I wanted to save as components as much as I can. Thanks.